Hi, my name is Christelle Torokov. I'm a mathematical physicist, and in my everyday life, I teach physics students mathematical methods. Previously, we saw that starting from Newtonian mechanics, studying the dynamics of a physical system, we arrived at some very important results, namely the conservation laws. In particular, we looked at the conservation of momentum and the conservation of energy. What we're going to do today is to connect those important results to a very fundamental idea in mathematics, namely the symmetry. And we start with looking at the symmetries of space. And there are fancy words for it, but I can't pronounce them, so I'm not going to say it. We start by saying that the space is the same everywhere. So if we have a physical system and we make a parallel transport of this entire physical system to anywhere in space, we don't expect the mechanical properties of that system to change. If you don't believe me, we can do a very simple calculation. So suppose I just have a one-dimensional system, and for our comfort, let's call it X. That's my horizontal direction here. And on this line, this one-dimensional line, I put a little particle of mass m, and it moves around along this one direction with some speed v, right? And suppose I decide that my origin and this frame marked with this line x starts right here. And then, of course, we all know we've got this momentum of this particle. And it's only in one dimension, so it's very easy to write it down. It's just mass times velocity. Now, what is velocity? It's the first time derivative of position. And we know it's position. It's this distance right here. And in this moment of time, it's this x here. And the first time derivative of position, dx dt. And that's my momentum for this particle of mass m. However, this origin here is completely arbitrary. Once I've chosen it, it's fixed. But where I choose it, should it matter? So suppose a friend of mine is observing exactly the same particle, but not knowing where I put my origin. My friend puts it, suppose it puts it right here. We call it with a little prime. That's a fancy mathematician notation. It's a different origin. We mark it with a prime so we can mark the distance where the particle is in his system with a little x prime. It just means it's different distance to the x that I had. And the momentum, of course, okay, just to make sure, this is my momentum, this p with a little x prime, that would be his momentum, but for the very same particle. So it's the same mass. Now, the velocity here, that would be the first time derivative of position, but in his coordinate system, which has position x prime. Now, that is a little bit odd because we expect the momentum to be the same because, after all, the particle is same, the velocity is same, but the coordinate systems are different. And that's what we mean by translational symmetry. We have a continuous translation here between my origin and his origin. And that distance here, it doesn't matter what it is. Let's call it alpha. It is some constant. Remember, when we choose origin, it's completely arbitrary. So my origin was arbitrary, his origin is arbitrary. Once it's chosen, it's fixed, and the distance between them is alpha. So the relationship between those two frames, if you like, is that his position, this x prime, is related to my coordinate x by taking away that constant alpha. And now, of course, because this alpha is a constant, what we can do is we take that relationship here and we put it in here. So we have mass times, and then we differentiate with respect to time. For x prime, we have x minus this constant alpha. If alpha is a constant, that means that the first or any derivative of this constant is zero. And therefore, what we get is precisely what we expected. We get back to the momentum that I had in my unprimed system. The important thing is that it is a continuous symmetry, because this alpha could be anything. It doesn't have to take any particular values. It's not like we get this result only if alpha is 5 or 10 or pi. It could be anything. So we have a continuous symmetry in space. And thus the momentum is conserved. So some of you may have noticed that I keep talking about this being a closed system or isolated system that we can parallel transport anywhere in space and get conserved quantities out of it. What does it mean, isolated system? That simply means that we don't have any external fields, no external forces that would ruin that beautiful symmetry for us. Suppose we take this particle now and we hold it midair, and we give it a horizontal velocity, absolutely horizontal velocity, and we throw it away. So schematically, here's my particle with mass m, and I've just thrown it away with this velocity v. Now, because it's got a mass and it's got velocity, that means it's got momentum. I do it midair, that means that I have two independent directions to take into account. One which is horizontal, and I also have the vertical direction. And likewise, my momentum vector, it will have two components. It will have an horizontal component, and it will have a vertical component. What happens horizontally? I'm just looking at this x direction, this horizontal direction, is that just like in the example before, there is no difference whether I'm here or here or here. There is symmetry. So the space looks exactly the same anywhere along this horizontal direction. So like in the example before, the horizontal momentum is conserved. And that simply means that if it wasn't for anything else, this particle that I've just thrown away with this horizontal velocity v, it will just carry on doing whatever it started off doing. Now, what happens vertically? And that's the interesting bit. Because now, remember, we're on Earth. There is an external player. It's called gravity, an external field. And gravity, it points down like that. Here's the gravitational acceleration. And what it does, this presence of an external field, is that it removes symmetry, not from the entire system, but just from this vertical direction. And we know that there is no symmetry in vertical direction because up is different to down. And since there is no symmetry in vertical direction, that means that the y component, the vertical component of momentum, is not conserved. And again, this is very easy to see if you actually do that experiment. You let go of this ball, you give them initial velocity in horizontal way, it carries on doing what it started off doing, but because of this external field, the final path of this particle will be down. And that is a difference between a closed system and a system that has external fields. And it is only when you have an isolated or closed system, when you have this beautiful perfect symmetry, as soon as you introduce external fields, they will remove the symmetry, and thus we don't have conserved quantities.